Why women? Well, the reason, obviously, because I am a man. And I'm probably curious about the female in reading about them, and I think that that's a much more interesting story for me. And I think that the muses that, and the women that we've chosen and worked with or about, I think that they all have probably a strange they probably have some kind of special story to them. I think some of them are much more demure than other ones, and I think that's what makes them interesting. You know, some of them are stronger, some of them probably have some kind of quite tragic and sad ending or midlife or whatever. First, it's Mary Mills Minter, Mildred, Emma, Olga, Nancy, Gertrude, Cindy, Tonya, Fanny, Sissy, Helena, Tina, Christina Mink, Candice Marie, Jody, Yuda, Diane, Laurie, Muriel, Lisa, Shelley, and Meryl. It's the last one. The first one was Marian Faithful. So it's called Marianne. It wasn't a sort of, as it is now, she wasn't so much as a thing for the degree collection, but it was some kind of way for me, again, to sort of create a kind of a world that I thought was right for what it is that I was doing at that point in time. I've always seen them as, for me, it's always been a very, that's why I call them a working tool, because they've always been a very good kind of way of me narrowing down what it is that I'm doing every time that I start up every season, so it doesn't get too floaty. And it also is a very perfect way for me to explain to the team that I work with, to whomever is going to be involved in the collections on a later stage, that they get the same kind of sense of what it is that I sort of want to get across. Because I always see it like that. What I am is I'm a designer. I'm trained as a fashion designer. I'm not trained to be a stylist. I'm not trained to be hair and makeup artist. There's professional people that does that job very well, but communicating with them becomes very crucial at that point when you're trying to build something up. And I think for me that's why I call them a working tool, because at the point of when they start coming in, I've sort of let go of them in a way, and I've sort of had too much. They can,
you're rest. Ready to share.
Yeah,
exactly. How they can touch them.
Yeah, exactly. They can do what they want with them. It's sometimes a funny thing, also working with these, you know, muses or whatever we call them, but muses is a perfectly fine word for them, I think. But some of them are well-known figures. So if you start too early on in the process of starting to talk about them with other people, they start getting their images of what it is. And that's why it's become a rule that we never talk about them before it's sort of is set in stone that this is what the work and the collection, what direction it's all going to go in. I think that's sort of an important peace of mind for us. I say us, it's not because I don't think I'm royal, but it's because I'm certainly not alone, but I have a team, you know, that I work with in the studio, and they are very much involved from the beginning.
Peter Jensens tøj er farverigt, det er sammensat, og det er skævt, det er uforfærdet og uimponeret.
I think we've been on, you know, on a long journey trying to find all the things that should go into the exhibition and what was relevant and did we actually have the garments still or did they have to be reproduced? And looking back at it now, I can see that there is a red thread throughout all the collections, which I am actually quite surprised about, if I have to say myself, because that I didn't expect that. I did expect that one collection was much more different than another collection, but as it happens, they do look like they belong together in some funny way, I think. It's a mind-boggling